This is an original Cuban poster by Olivio Martinez celebrating the 20th anniversary of the Cuban Revolution. This poster had a clean rip all the way across, and we mended it on a linen backing at Poster Fix. Hi, I'm Chris, and welcome to Poster Fix Studio.
When I got this Cuban poster, it was ripped in two pieces, and it's got missing paper there and a rip here. And down here is the second half of the poster. So I have to put these two pieces together on the linen backing. I've decided to put the wheat paste directly to the paper because this poster is very, very dry and fragile and is prone to ripping easily.
Olivio Martinez is the artist who designed this poster, and he has also designed many other Cuban posters. Some of them are very internationally well known in the poster world.
Now I'm spraying it with water to help it absorb and expand. Taking the roller and gently pushing out the air pockets and the excessive wheat paste.
This poster is from 1973 and represents the 20th anniversary of the birth of the revolution, the 26th of July, 1953. The Cuban Revolution was an armed revolt conducted by Fidel Castro and his allies against the military dictatorship of Cuban President Batista. The revolution began in July of 1953 and continued sporadically until the rebels finally ousted Batista on the 31st of December 1958, replacing his government. The 26th of July 1953 is celebrated in Cuba as the Day of the Revolution. The 26th of July movement, later reformed along Marxist-Leninist lines, becoming the Communist Party of Cuba in October of 1965. The Cuban Revolution had powerful domestic and international repercussions. In particular, it transformed Cuba-United States relations, although efforts to improve diplomatic relations have made great strides in recent years. And as a side note, the Castro family has just ceded power. But let's go back to the beginning. In the immediate aftermath of the revolution, Castro's government began a program of nationalization, centralization of the press, and political consolidation that transformed Cuba's economy and civil society. The revolution also heralded an era of Cuban intervention in foreign military conflicts in Africa, Latin America, Southeast Asia, and the Middle East. Several rebellions occurred in the 6 years following 1959, mainly in the Escambray Mountains, which were repressed by the revolutionary government.
I've got the poster linen backed, and it's sharing a screen with all these other posters. We're going to let this solidarity poster dry for a few days on this screen before we finally trim it down and touch it up. So don't go away, we'll be right back.
We are burnishing. This is a way of flattening out the ridges and creases in the paper and must be done before we touch it up. Oki is using paper pulp to fill in the small bits of missing paper around the edges of the poster. I'm doing the color retouching using watercolor pencils and watercolor markers. This is an archival way of doing restoration, and it is water reversible. My wife Oki is using water reversible paints to touch up the areas of the poster that have had paper fills put in. You're probably wondering, is a poster fix compatible with archival standards and practices? Or in other words, is our process of linen backing a process that is accepted as a means of preserving a vintage poster? And the answer is generally yes. Generally, because most collectors, auction houses, museums, and so forth, respect and acknowledge the benefits of linen backing, provided it is archival linen backing. There are some areas of archiving old paper ephemera where linen backing may not be chosen as the option for preservation. There are other means to preserve vintage paper. However, those means are not always practical to the everyday collector and displayer of vintage posters. They have to do with encapsulating the poster inside Mylar and giving it a special acid bath and keeping it out of light and keeping it basically out of circulation. Linen backing is a generally good way to make the poster usable, enjoyable, displayable. And in most cases, a linen-backed poster will fetch better prices at sales than one that is not preserved. Well, there you have it. Another poster restored at Poster Fix. I appreciate you coming to my channel and watching my videos. Remember, at Poster Fix, we bring your vintage posters back to life.